Hi there. Welcome. Thank you for joining Miss Bianchi and Hazel. Hazel is my miniature pincher in our fall drawing lesson. I'm including Hazel in this because occasionally you'll hear from her. So what we're going to do today is draw some pumpkins, some realistic pumpkins, not whimsical this week. We're going to look at shape and color and shading and all that fun stuff. I've already put my ground line down because I want to make sure that my drawings don't go to the edge. And I've already placed on one side the height of my one pumpkin, which is going to be my larger one on this side. And then I'm going to do a smaller pumpkin about yay big right here. And I'm going to make sure that I do not go beyond that size. Okay, so what I would like to just make sure that we know is that don't worry, don't stress about any of the lines that I'm making in comparison to you, because this is your drawing and feel free to go ahead and express yourself in any which way. And it's not supposed to look like my drawing. So just make sure that you feel comfortable with your drawing skills. I'm going to go ahead and start drawing the pumpkin on this side. And what I'm doing is I'm doing some very large curved lines. Kind of looks like a vitamin when you really put it all together. So I'm going to go ahead and draw the vitamin shape right there in the center. This is going to be my very first part of the pumpkin. And then I'm going to take some more curved lines. Could be like a really elongated C. I'm going to start it from almost to the top and end it close to the bottom. And then do the opposite on the other side. Right. Okay. And then I'm going to do one more on each side. Again, starting almost at the top and ending almost at the bottom, like that. Okay. There's our pumpkin. Now, looking at mine, it looks like I need a little bit of some background because I've noticed that I'm leaving some space here that seems like should be more pumpkins. So I'm going to go ahead and draw just a couple of curved lines like that to give the illusion that that pumpkin is a full pumpkin. Let's not forget the stem. So I'm going to draw the stem from here. And it's just going to be a little curvy any which direction. Bring this to meet that. And there's our first pumpkin. Now I'm going to do a smaller pumpkin over here. I'm going to start with, again, like a pill shape here. Using my guidelines. That way I don't go any larger or any closer to the edge of the paper. So that's our center panel. To the sides of our pumpkin. And it's okay if our lines are crooked, if they're a little bumpy, because a lot of pumpkins I've seen lately are not your perfect pumpkin. There's our smaller pumpkin. And I'm going to go ahead and do what I did before. I'm going to add those curves on the back. Maybe couple more over here. And that was Hazel chasing my cat. Yeah, life at home. So challenging with all these animals. Okay, and let's not forget the stem. So the stem is going to come up on this one. I'm going to just make it have a straight stem like this. And maybe have like a little offshoot here. You can do that any which way you'd like. Making it curve. Everyone's got an opinion. That's Audrey, by the way. Audrey and Hazel love each other, can't you tell? Okay, so there's just like a little branch coming off of the stem and off of the little branch. I'm going to do just a cute little leaf like that. Nothing fancy, just a couple of curved lines. If you wanted to do another one, you can do another leaf down here. Almost looks like a heart. Actually, that one doesn't look like a heart, but how about that one? So we got three leaves now. Okay. So we have two pumpkins. We've got one mama, one baby. And we, if we wanted to do what we did over here on this side, where we have a stem, like a little branch coming off of the stem, we can do something like that. And it could be thin, but I always like to include a double line because everything in nature has some width to it. Okay, so we have two pumpkins. Now, I'd like to color them. So we're gonna color our pumpkins and I'm gonna give you some choices. I'm gonna give you some choices whether to use a marker or colored pencils. But what I'm going to demonstrate for you, because later, if you want to go purchase these for yourself, and there's my cat. Oh my gosh. If you want to purchase these for yourself later, I'm going to show you how to use watercolor pencils. So it's something you can pick up at Michael's or even Amazon. I prefer the Crayola brand because they're inexpensive and they're just as good as any other brand. So I'm going to use these, but I will show you how to use colored pencils in the shading, and then I'm just going to add a little water to it to create that watercolor pencil effect. But do not add water to regular colored pencils because the it's just going to make a mess for you. Okay, so here's what I'm going to start with. And I did mention that you can use markers because we are dealing with some large spaces here. Oh my goodness, I think I need a babysitter for this. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and add color, obviously, to our pumpkin. And if you want to just use a marker because you'd rather have a more solid color, that's fine. I love watercolor pencils. I love regular colored pencils because they give a little bit more sense of texture. And it's just, you can always add to them too. You can color on top of them. So I'm adding color to my pumpkin. So if you're just using regular colored pencils, I'm going to recommend that you fill the whole space. Taking your time. No stress. The hard part's over. Now the fun coloring part. So coloring your background. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna demonstrate for you. If you do decide to get colored pencil, watercolor pencils, I'm gonna demonstrate how to turn that into a watercolor. I got a really basic and small brush. I have the itsiest amount of water here because what's the rule of thumb? You only want to use as much water as you want to clean up, right? In case you make an accident. And I'm just going to take that wet paintbrush and paint over my watercolor pencils. My brush was too dry. And if you notice, I am drawing towards the center, painting towards the center, drawing the colors that I just placed on the paper, my watercolor pencil. I bring it to the center ever so lightly, so it's nice and light, and the edges here are darker. I'm going to go ahead and move on and color the rest of my pumpkin. So I wanted to demonstrate that for you because I want it to dry. I'm going to add more color on top of it, but you don't want to add color on top of wet. That is a certain technique, but in this case, I want it to be dry. Again, this can be done in regular colored pencils. You do not have to use watercolor pencils. But I thought it might be fun for you guys to experiment if you do have the ability to get them. Gonna keep coloring. I definitely recommend putting some nice soothing music on when you do this. Put you in a creative mindset. Now I am going to apply some water to these watercolor pencils also, but first what I want to do, I'm going to add a little bit more color on top of it. Don't you love how colored pencils look? Gives you that real rustic, real beautiful texture. Okay, so what I would want to do now is I'm going to add a little bit of a darker color on top of my orange. So I don't have a vast array of watercolor pencils here, so I'm going to add actually a brown. And I'm going to add the brown where my pencil line is. And I'm just going to do it ever so lightly. But I am going to apply some thickness. So you'll notice that my line does have some thickness to it because I want to be able to draw the color from this line. I'll show you what that looks like in a little bit. If you're using regular color pencils, you're going to do the same thing. And also from the bottom. So basically we're putting the color, the darker color, where the little shadow effect's gonna be. So this is a real bumpy pumpkin. So it has some shadows where the bumps of the pumpkin are, right? Looking pretty good. This little bump back here is going to be a little bit darker because it's going to be behind the pumpkin. So it's going to be a little darker. The shadow is going to be deeper. See how I'm coloring that? Well, let's not forget, we're gonna need to put some brown over here too, because remember, pumpkin is curved. So right here, there's gonna be a shadow because it's curving to the back. We'll do that on the both sides of the pumpkin. So the bottom here, okay, is curving under. So this center is nice and dry, so I can put the colored pencil over it. Okay. Almost don't forget the top because it's going to be curving inwards towards the step. Okay. Just a little bit of color there. And let's see if that was enough. I'll just put a tad bit more. So I want to give this a little bit thicker line because remember, I'm going to put the wet brush over it and I'm going to draw this color into the center of this panel. Let's see if I've done it enough. So I'm not using watercolor brushes. I'm just using a regular brush that I have at home, which means it does tend to hold a lot of water. So what I usually do is I'll take the brush and I'll kind of squeeze a little bit of the water. So now I am taking my wet brush over the brown and I'm going to blend it towards the center of this particular panel. On the pumpkin. And do that with all of the different panels of the pumpkin. You can move your drawing around. You don't have to draw or paint in an awkward position. I'm doing it so you can see what I'm working on here. Don't move in too much. There. Keep doing this. Trying to draw the brown into the pumpkin. Center of the pumpkin. I should say the center of the panel. Not forget the top. Like I mentioned before, we can actually do multimedia here. We could do markers as the base, and then we can add some more color and texture with our colored pencils. I'm going to let that dry because I'm going to add some more color on top of that. But what we can do in the meantime is we can work on our stem. And I think I'm going to create, how about a green stem? It's a nice fresh pumpkin. So I'm going to create a green stem here. And I'm going to fill this in pretty dark. I'm only doing the sides because I'm going to use, like I said, my watercolor pencil to draw the color in towards the center. I don't know if I'll use the watercolor brush at the end of this. I'm going to just color this all in. That's the beauty of the watercolor pencil, is you can use it just as colored pencils. You don't necessarily have to apply water to it. Especially this one, since it's so thin. We're not going to water this one down. Before I wet it down, though, I think I want to add some brown to it. see what that looks like when we blend it. Again, don't need to use watercolor pencils. If you're not using watercolor pencils, you would just continue to color in the stem with your colored pencil. And there's our stem. So as this pumpkin dries, we're going to go ahead and move on to this pumpkin right over here. Continue coloring in as if you were using colored pencils. I'm actually going to have this pumpkin be a little brighter, so I'm coloring in much darker and deeper. And I'm going to apply water on top. But I wanted to keep this nice deep color. That's why I'm not leaving any, or I'm not leaving much of the space white. I also want to experiment by putting some brown on top of this before I wet it and see if my colors will blend that way. Thinking about those bumps in the back. I'm not going to erase these pencil lines though, because when you're using watercolors, they're not too forgiving. So you want to erase any lines that you don't want to see. Okay. I'm gonna add some brown. Right here where I left the white. I'm gonna do a little bit of lighter coloring. So right there at the crease, it's really dark brown. And then I'm gonna go in towards the center of this particular panel. It's a little bit of a lighter touch. That looks pretty good already, right? Don't need to add the watercolor. I should say the water to the color if you didn't want to. Like I said, you can always use watercolor pencils, just regular colored pencils, if you didn't want to do the fuss and the muss of the watercolor. If you hear that neighbor dog barking. And since this is the edge or the end of the pumpkin, I'm including the brown there too. Thank you. definitely should add smaller brush. Just have to use the edges of the brush to get into those small areas. Okay. Hazel. No one likes a critic. Okay, so I'm going to wet my brush. We're going to apply this, and you'll notice that it's much brighter. Much brighter. Because I actually applied quite a bit of color there. I'm going to draw the brown towards the center. Just using the tip of this brush. Okay. We'll let that dry. Because I like to layer colors on top of each other. For example, right here, this pumpkin, I'd like to add some yellows to this pumpkin. Just give it a little bit more brighter look. And I'm not even gonna, these are watercolor pencils, but I'm not even gonna use the water. I'm just gonna leave it with the yellow. That makes it pop a little bit more. I think I do want to make sure that I put some color where this white is, though. I left too many white spots there. Still adding yellow, just give it some variety of pumpkin color. I also want to come back with my brown. Because the watercolor, or I should say the brush, which is not a watercolor brush, it's just a regular brush, erased too much of my brown. So I like how the brown is deep in the crease, but I do want to bring it a little bit out into the pumpkin panel. That's not a technical word. I don't know how to describe those little bumpy things. Okay, so I'm going to bring it in. The panel there. Just to show you the shadow it's creating. Some volume for pumpkin. And it's okay to do a nice dark line like that. Very lightly coloring the brown very lightly. I want to see a gradual value change in my brown. I don't want to see a drastic one. It's okay that we have a drastic line. It's okay there, but where the color is coming into the pumpkin, you want it to be a little bit smoother transition. A little darker at the bottom here. To show that the pumpkin is curved in at the bottom. We can even add some brown to our stem. Okay, now one thing, let's see here. What else do I want to do? I want to make sure that we really bring out the shape of the pumpkin, making those lines and the creases of the pumpkin nice and dark. I can actually use a marker here if you wanted to. Typically, I would recommend a Sharpie, but since we're using brown, dark brown is good enough. But if you did have a black colored pencil, maybe that's what I'll do. Just a very thin line. Just to show deep creasing. And you can make this pumpkin any color you want, really. We could do the same technique. We were doing a white pumpkin, actually. So we don't lose the details. One last thing before we finish this pumpkin over here. Let's not forget that these are sitting on something, so they're going to project a little shadow here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this brown to kind of create a shadow. And I'm going to just do a little shadow, kind of like if you were to do like parallel lines to these lines that we've created here. But not a big one, not a big one. So I'm creating that little shadow for that pumpkin. I'm going to also do that on this side. Almost kind of looks like a puddle, right? But this puddle is actually a shadow. Coloring that in. I'm not going too dark on it. I think I do want to use my watercolor brush to blend that in. Give it a subtle look. kind of blur the line that I drew. Shadows don't always have an outline, do they? Kind of blurred. So that is our little shadow for our pumpkin. If you wanted to do it a different color, you could. You know, you have some creative license in your design. You could have done it black. Actually, I'll do this one black so we can see what that looks like. See how much darker it comes out. So you don't even have to use the watercolors, do you? Just using your colored pencil. Create that shadow. So I wanted to start with a pumpkin because pumpkins are nice bumpy. So if you were a little concerned about your drawing skills, no one would judge you because pumpkins look like, you know, some pumpkins are beautiful, some tend to be a little bit bumpier, so it's okay to have some bumpy ones, right? So I'm adding some black to over here. Put in some deep black where the pumpkin actually meets the surface. That'll be its darkest shadow. That's your shadow. Okay. And since I'm doing watercolors on this one, we are going to wet this and see how that looks. I'm not going to put a lot of water on it. I don't want to diffuse black too much. Just want to draw it into the brown. Again, don't have a lot of brushes here, so I'm using this last one here. Just to blend it. There's our shadow there. Need a little bit more here. Okay. So let's not forget, we gotta finish this stem over here. We still have a pumpkin stem to do. I'm going to do this one green as well. The thinner areas. Definitely not going to use the water to bring up the watercolors, especially with the limited amount of brushes I have here. Just going to color that in nice and deep. I'm going to leave this a little bit lighter here so I can show that it's curving down. And the light's going to hit right there, so that'll be the lightest part of the leaf. And then as it curves down, it'll be darker. Okay. Not bad. We could add some water to that if we wanted to blend in that stem, but it looks pretty darn good the way it is. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. You got some pumpkins that you can either choose to use watercolor pencils to have a little fun with it. If you don't have the proper utensils for watercoloring, no big deal. Colored pencils. I hope I shared with you some shading techniques. There you go. We got our little bumpy pumpkins.